Hi, and welcome to episode 1 of my Figura tutorial series. In this episode, I'm going to be going over the very basics of how to install and use Figura. I'm not going to be showing how to create an avatar in this episode, just how to use everything. Pretty simple. So first off, I guess, what is Figura? So Figura is a client-side mod, which is for Fabric, and it allows you to just change your player model extensively, which is really nice. Alright, so the first thing you're obviously gonna want to do is install it. So I'm gonna quickly walk you through that. So I'm gonna go Figura Modrinth, because Modrinth is a billion times better than Curse Forge. You'll see a page like this, and you want to download the latest version. Whatever version you download, by the way, make sure you take a note of what Minecraft version it's for. I'm going to be downloading for 1.19.4, but you might be doing something newer or older than that, so just keep that in mind. So grab the file you want, download it. Pretty simple. I mean, you've downloaded a mod before, probably. After that, you're going to need the Fabric installer. So Fabric installer Minecraft, go here, download for Windows if you're using Windows. If you're using like Linux or something, you might need to download the jar, but you can figure that out. Open the installer, and now you want to select your Minecraft version. It's already 1.19.4 for me, so that's what I'm going to select. You should then be fine to just hit install. And done, just like that. So now if I open up Minecraft, I've not opened up the launcher in a very long time. Alright, so you see we've got Fabric installed, but we still need to add Figura, but that's really simple. Just hit the Windows key and type %appdata%, and then open this folder here. You want to hit .minecraft, mods, and then you want to go to your downloads folder. You want to grab the Figura file, drag it into the mods folder, and then you can just launch the game. And there we go. It has now started. So if I just join a world here, you can see Figura should be working, and it is. All right, so let's show you how to use this mod. When you press the escape menu, you'll notice this new icon here. This is the Figura icon. When you click it, you get this menu. Now you won't have all these avatars, and you probably won't even have an avatar equipped, but I just have all this here to help demonstrate how everything's gonna work. All right, so yeah, in the wardrobe screen, you have your avatars down here. You can obviously select them by just clicking on the avatars. However, when you do this, other people won't see these changes. It is client-side only. When I click the reload avatar button, it'll fetch my avatar from the backend and show you what everyone else sees. And you can see it's still my avatar. To change my avatar, I would have to click the upload avatar button. And then when I reload, you can see it fetches this one. Whenever you select an avatar, make sure you both upload and reload the avatar to make sure everything's syncing properly. To deselect your avatar, you can click this button here. And to delete your avatar from the Figura backend, you can click this button. You can access your avatar roots folder, clean this folder up here. You can also drag to rotate your avatar. You can right click to pan, and you can open this so you can see things a little further out. You can zoom and stuff. It's pretty handy to, you know, look at what everything looks like in game. You can also check if you're connected to the Figura backend up here. If it's like red and says backend not connected, then, you know, other people won't be able to see anything, and you won't be able to see other people. If your avatar has custom sounds, when you click up here, you'll be able to see them all in here. And if your avatar has keybinds, which this one doesn't, one sec. If your avatar has keybinds, you'll be able to see them all here, and you'll even be able to rebind them. Next up, we have the permissions screen. This is basically where you set how laggy people's avatars are allowed to be. So you know, you can block people and their avatars won't work anymore. You can set it to low and the avatars will only be able to do very basic things. You can see when you don't have enough permissions, this badge pops up. And if they're your friend, you can set the permissions to high or max. You can also control this through this handy slider here. And if they're errored, make sure you just reload their avatar. Now, of course, there's only me here because I'm on a server by myself. But there's still other people's avatars here. And that's just through player heads. You can still manage that if you click the Show Disconnected Avatars button. And all of a sudden, all these avatars pop up. And you can manage all their permissions still. You can also choose to only show Figura players if, you know, you're on a big server with lots of people. You can also, like, search, which is pretty obvious. You can also hit the up arrow here and you'll see the advanced settings. You can select this for either an entire category or individual players if you want. So you can change, like, how many particles are allowed, or how many sounds are allowed, the avatar volume, animation complexity, everything here. You can right-click to reset to default as well. And of course, yeah, same thing for category. You can also click precise mode here and you'll be able to insert individual numbers if you want. Now, an important note here is that by default on Mac settings, avatars have infinite instructions for most things. So basically, be careful who you put on Macs because they can hang your client and basically crash your game. You can change this if you want by changing the sliders to not quite be infinite. It's up to you, really. But it's best to put people on high instead of max, basically. Finally, we have the settings. There's a lot of settings, but you can read all the descriptions with the little pop-up that appears over the text, but I'll just quickly show you some useful ones. If you want, you can have an optional paper doll. This will appear in the corner of your screen. Nice if you just want to be able to see your avatar. You can bound a panic button. I like to set this to F12. Basically, like, if someone's lagging you, like, a ton, you can just hit the panic button. Figure is just disabled, and you can sort out the issues, block the person if you want, and just re-enable once everything's back to normal. And that's all the major settings, in my opinion. Alright, so I've kind of glossed over probably the most important thing, and that's actually, where do you get avatars? Obviously, for you. You won't have all these avatars here. In fact, it'll look something like this. Completely empty. Now, fortunately, there's plenty of community-made avatars on the Discord that you can download. If you don't have a Discord account, you can just quickly create one. So if you just click in the help section, go to Discord, open a browser, and this will bring you to the Moonlight server. You can also access this by going to Discord, clicking Explore Servers, searching for Moonlight like I did here, and clicking on the server, joining the server, going through onboarding, and then you're in the server. Now, the main thing you want to look at is Showcase Place and Avatar Showcase. This is where everyone posts their avatars. Not everyone posts with a download link though, as you can see like here, for example. So if you just click the download available tag up here, it'll filter it to have all the avatars that you can download. So for example, if I downloaded this creeper, open it up, and then go into game, open up the folder, drag this in, that didn't want to work. You can see it appears just in here. I can upload it, other people could then see it. And now I'm a creeper. You can also just drag and drop the zip file, and that works too. Some avatars will have customization options, which you can access by pressing the action wheel button. The default button for that is B. You can see this doesn't have anything, but yeah. I'm just joining the game as my alt, and you can see when I go find myself, I'm a creeper. Anyway, this has been the very basics of installing and using Figura. In the next episode, I'm going to be going over how to actually start making your own avatar, which is actually really simple. I hope this has been helpful, and I hope you enjoyed. See ya!